Again, without comment. Okay, I repeat once more, and I have a question. This patient should have two independent thyroid diseases simply viewing this video. The first is the nodule in the left lobe, and what is the other disease which this patient must have? Any idea?
Thyroiditis.
Please?
Thyroiditis.
Thyroiditis,
Thyroiditis.
yes. It is. I think it is quite obvious in the right lobe that this is the focal form of lymphocytic thyroiditis. There are many small hyperkic areas within an econormal background, so this is a typical presentation of thyroiditis. And here is the nodule in the left lobe. And at the second video, I focus only on the nodule. So this nodule occurred in a hypoechoic thyroid, and this is a seemingly isoechoic nodule, but please remember, this is a healthy thyroid. This is not from this case. This is a other patient. The healthy thyroid had above 80 pixel, mean pixel of echogenicity, 80. This at 70. So if we compare this nodule to healthy thyroid, that this nodule should be regarded as minimally moderately hypoechoic. If we compare this nodule to the extranodular parenchyma, yes, this was already presented in the brief summary. So it is clearly lighter than the extranodular parenchyma. So if our reference tissue regarding normal thyroid would be the extranodular thyroid, then the nodule should be considered as isohyperechoic, and no one thyroid suggests fine respiration cytology. If the normal thyroid as reference tissue would be a healthy thyroid, then this nodule would be a minimally moderately hyperthyroid, and two of the thyroids gave the patient the chance to recognize their malignant follicular cancer. Comments, questions?
No, I don't have.
One more comment from me. I don't think that each and every isoechoic nodules should be sampled, but a nodule which has halo sign, okay, we know that halo is a benign sign in general, but the halo is one of the ultrasound signs of a follicular tumor, including follicular cancer. By definition, a follicular cancer should be surrounded with capsule. If the pathologist does not find an intact capsule, then the lesion could not be a follicular tumor. And the more important sign of the capsule is the halo. So the halo is a controversial sign. In general, it is much rarely found in malignant diseases because almost 90% of all malignant thyroid cancers are papillary one. But if we neglect the presence of halo, then we will not recognize follicular cancers. So I think that in those isohyperechoic or econormal lesions which has halo, aspiration cytology is, on my opinion, mandatory. Otherwise, we have no chance to recognize follicular cancer less than 2 centimeter in diameter. And this 2 centimeter has a very important relevance. It is generally accepted that the follicular cancer less than 2 centimeter in diameter only exceptionally gives distant metastasis. By this chance of distant metastasis significantly increases if the nodule becomes larger than 2 centimeters. So I think that an isoechoic nodule presenting hero sign and less than 2 centimeters, I think at least FNAs should be considered. I perform in all such cases. Please.
May I have a question?
Please.
Because, well, traditionally a hello sign in a nodule, it says benign. I understood your point of view, yes, that the follicular can be isoechoic with a hello. But I would say the hello, in this case, it's a little bit, it's not that thin, it's thicker.
Maybe you have right. Okay, I know that most guidelines suggest that thick halo is a sign of malignant diseases, but I can present you, and I will present in the chapter section 6 under thyroid cancers some cases which are absolutely not thick halo. Okay, you may think that here is a second halo, and maybe you have absolute right, but I don't think that this is a very precise science if you regard only on thick halo. And
okay,
I will present once more
I mean I would not consider it suspicious to take a sample by finding the last aspiration in that nodule you just presented. I don't know.
Okay.
But I don't see, maybe I'm wrong.
Do you see summary? No.
Yes, I do.
Yes, okay. Yes. I try to find this figure from Yeh and co-workers. So almost 90% of follicular cancers have halo sign. No one had microcalcifications. 40%, not 40, that's the smooth margin. Yes, this is the benign sign, the smooth and not the irregular. Flat shape, it means that not taller than wide sign. So in all cases, this is a benign sign, a flat shape, isohyper benign sign, smooth margin benign sign, halo sign, benign sign. But these are represented, follicular cancer is represented, characterized by these features. So if we have the intention to recognize follicular cancers, we cannot rely on the suggestions of thyroids. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
I think we have one.